been in a heated confrontation where the right person said the wrong thing to you? Splash show hands. Next time that happened to you, why don't you reach for a glass of iced tea? Me and my wife went to McDonald's about a month ago. Now, the McDonald's we go to, the only employee that's smiling is Ronald McDonald. Service is very good. You order chicken nuggets, you don't get any sweet and sour sauce. You order french fries, you don't get any ketchup. You order 6 cheeseburgers, it'll give you 3 burgers on a good night. So needless to say, we were kind of worried about going to this particular McDonald's, but it was like the last resort for us. So we go through the drive-thru, you know, order our food, get to the window to pay for our food. My wife proceeds to hand the cashier her debit card. Cashier snatches it out of her hand. My wife looks at her, you know, gives her a rude smirk or whatever. And then we see this figure approaching the front of our car. It's kind of dark, you can't really see what it is, but this person just comes out of nowhere. Chandra! Chandra! Why you tell me he's working tonight, girl? Let me get some cheeseburgers, some french fries, and some iced tea. So he comes up to the front of our car. My wife's at the, you know, sitting in the driver's side. He's trying to get to the cashier right here. So he's sitting on the hood trying to shimmy over, but he can't quite get over there. So he goes around the back of that car. He's touching my car as he's going around the back. So he gets over to the driver's side and he leans into the cashier, starts hugging and kissing and everything. His pants are sagging down, you know, so his underwear is in my wife's face. She's having a fit. So I'm like, honey, why don't you get the debit card? You know, this heard of all these scams happening. I don't know if she slipped the debit card in his shirt pocket or something like that. So I'm like, go ahead and get the debit card back. She says, excuse me. So the guy turns around, he leaves. But Chandra takes my wife's debit card and she throws it in her face. And she says, you don't have to be rude. You know, you're interrupting our conversation. Go to the next one, they'll have your food for you. So I have to promise to buy my wife a new pair of shoes and an outfit just to keep her from jumping in the window and attacking Chandra, the cashier. I figured that the money I would have spent on bail was probably comparable in price to shoes and an outfit. So we go to the next one, we get our food, we check in our bag. Obviously, they didn't give us any ketchup. We didn't get any sauce. We got to ask for that. So we get the condiments and everything. My wife takes a little sip of her tea before we pull off. She's like, I asked for sweet tea. This isn't sweet. So we go all the way back around to the drive-thru, skip the drive-thru, go back to Chandra's window. And as we get there, my wife and Chandra are arguing about the iced tea. So this goes on for about a couple minutes. I'm just sitting in the passenger side like, wow, okay. And so finally, Chandra's like, well, how do I even know you didn't drink it all? You just trying to get something for free. Man, that was strike number 3 right there. My wife takes the lid off the iced tea, and she baptizes Chandra. How many people by nice. Show of hands have been to the Lowry Park Zoo? I took my family just this past August for my son's birthday, and I think we found out how hot hell really is. I mean, it was so hot, it was scorching. Miracles were happening. There are people 300 pounds walking in. They left the zoo 100 pounds with muscles. Women were pushing baby strollers that had just had a pile of dust in the bottom there. Babies just evaporated out of thin air. And people were actually mad at the animals because the animals weren't coming out of their enclosures. I mean, I couldn't expect them to come out. It was hot. I imagine if I was an animal, I'd probably rather die by getting eaten by something, not from heat stroke. You know, it's in an animal's nature to probably go out with a bang, you know, some excitement of being chased and being killed. But as we were going into the zoo, there was a bunch of bees just buzzing around. I was like, man, this would be a bad day for someone with bee allergies. So I actually went into the zoo, and there was this guy who left his EpiPen at home, and he actually had bee allergies. So he's swatting away crazily, he can't control himself, and he finally gets to me. He's like, what's up, brother? I'm like, what's up, how are you doing? You all right, man? I left my EpiPen at home. I'm allergic to bees. If I get stung, it's gonna be a real trouble. You know, so I look at him like, well, you probably shouldn't swipe at him. You might want to go home. You know, I'd be like a person with peanut allergy sticking peanuts in their mouth and spitting them out. You know, it's not a real safe thing to do. So after I told him that, that was probably the best advice he's gotten in his life. We didn't talk anymore. He just kind of sat there and stared at me for a little bit. Until about a dozen more bees, they started swimming around him. I guess they knew he was allergic and they were just attacking him. You know, this is for all the human beings that swat bees. So they were buzzing around him crazily. He just took off running around the corner. And I'm with my son. My son's looking like, Dad, look. Turning to my son, like, son, it's okay. He'll be with Jesus really soon. I had the privilege of playing basketball this past weekend with the next military veteran. But he wasn't an ordinary veteran at all. No, this guy was homeless and he wasn't quite all there.
But I was at a full court. There's about five courts with us. And we had maybe 40 to 50 people out there just playing full court basketball. And I was just waiting to get into a pickup game. So this guy just approaches me out of the blue, and he just stares at me in the face for like 5 minutes. Now that's not 5 minutes, but you can probably imagine how uncomfortable that made me feel. I felt like he was dissecting my DNA, my X and Y chromosome, just my genetic makeup. He was just looking at me really strange. And so he finally greets me like this. Now he was Caucasian. He said, "My name is Jeff and I'm a black man." "My name is Jeff and I'm a black man." And so I'm like, "Okay, brother." So he stuck his hand out like that. We did a fist bump and he invited me to play a game of basketball. Now this wasn't any ordinary game of basketball. Jeff was a Caucasian black male that made up his own rules. Rule number one, dribbling was optional. Jeff would dribble when he felt like it, and he would carry the ball when he felt like it. Rule number two, if Jeff shoots the ball and he misses, Jeff gets the ball back. I learned that the hard way. He shot, he missed, I got the rebound. I was gonna take it back out to come back in for a layup. Jeff like, no, my ball. I gave him the ball back, I wanted to be nice that day. Rule number three, Jeff always wins the game. And I had to let Jeff win because I didn't want to die that day because he was a little bit off. But every time he would take the ball out, he would do like some funky robot dance with gun signs. So I let him win the game that day. So what have we learned today? Ice-T can cool off the hottest situation. Kim and Bees brings out the little girl in all of us. And basketball can bring the strangest of people together. Thank you.
That 1 minute on the clock and 1 minute of silence, please.